Radio 1.
Radio 1 podcast. The Scott Mills Daily.
Now, I know I'm not the first person to say this to you, dear listener, but happy White Stripes Wednesday.
Happy White Stripes Wednesday to you, Scott. Happy White Stripes Wednesday.
Yeah. They did an amazing live lounge earlier, and Jo was down there speaking to them at Maida Vale. However, before she left on one of those showbiz taxi bikes to go to the Maida Vale studios this morning, in a summer dress, very unwise.
Why have you tried that?
Yeah. She made a startling admission to us.
Did she?
She really doesn't like interviewing the White Stripes.
Why is that?
Not because they're not nice people.
Right. Don't go down that road again.
Would you like to guess? It's quite an embarrassing reason.
Really?
Mm.
I don't know.
Why do you think it might be?
I don't know. I don't know.
Right.
I can't think of anything. Right. Because she's normally so accomplished with anybody.
Mm. She's a very good interviewer.
Yeah.
But there's something about White Stripes that puts her right off.
Does she not like interviewing boys and girls together?
No.
I don't know.
Jo, if you're listening, I'm going to give you the length of the Chemical Brothers track, which is 3 minutes and 6 seconds, to call the studio if you don't want me to say what the reason is that you don't like interviewing the White Stripes. So give us a call, Jo. So many reasons coming in now on the text as to why Jo might not have the White Stripes as a favourite interview in the world. Hello, Radio 1.
Hello.
Hello, who's that?
It's Jamie.
Hello, Jamie, where are you?
I'm on my way home to Crewe from Altrincham.
Okay, yeah, how can I help?
Is it because she used to date one of the members?
What, which one, Meg or Jack?
I don't know the names.
A lot of people are hoping that it's Meg on the text.
Don't think that's true, is it? No. Man, I don't know the reason.
So. No, that's not the reason. Hi, Jo.
Don't you dare.
Oh,
I'm going to kill Laura.
I'm so glad that you called me during that song. And what are the chances of that? You listening to my show this afternoon?
It's very rare.
I know. It's a good job that we're not going to say it, isn't it?
Is it bad?
It's quite. It's not. Well, it's nothing. No, it's not. It's not about them as people. We love them very much, don't you, Jo?
Very much.
Why have you gone all giggly though?
It's just a bit. Can you give us a clue, Jo?
I sometimes find it difficult to maintain eye contact.
Right. See, that's all we need to know. Thanks very much for
clearing
up.
What, with Meg?
No, the other one. Okay, bye! Hello?
Hello, Scott. Hello. Kate.
Hello, Kate. Where are you?
Chesterfield.
Okay, how can I help today?
I think I know why Jo doesn't want to interview Jack.
What? Why?
Is it because he's got a rather large manhood?
Well, a lot of people are saying that on the text.
Beautifully put.
Yeah. We can't confirm or deny that to be the case, but if that's what you're gathering from what Jo just said, then so be it.
Well, I think that's the type of girl Jo is, you see.
No, hang on a second. No, just to stick up for Whiley there, right? It's only the same as blokes looking at
boobs,
isn't it?
Yeah, but as
and it's not the fact that she's checking
to girls. Do girls check your bits out?
No, sometimes. Laura was saying this earlier. Sometimes you just get awareness. Are you with me on this?
That means nothing. What do you mean, get awareness?
Well, sometimes their trousers will be quite tight, and awareness just happens.
I can't say it's the first thing I look at.
No, you're not looking at it on purpose. It's just that it's prominent.
All right.
Yeah, but that was the other way around.
Kate, are you saying this has never happened to you, Kate? Have you never got the awareness problem?
I don't know. I don't think so. Right. I might have done it subconscious.
Yeah. I mean, it's different though, because boobs are kind of out there and you can't miss them. Whereas you'd have to be really, well, mate, in some cases you wouldn't have to be really looking, but you'd have to kind of be actually staring at that region.
No, you wouldn't. You'd be surprised.
What?
Seriously, loads of girls will now back me up on this.
That you just all of a sudden become aware of a willy.
8-1-1-9. Don't say you don't learn anything on this show.
I keep looking down at myself now to see whether I can see anything.
No, you don't need to be paranoid about it. Right, so many girls are backing me up now on this thing. It's a common problem, isn't it, Laura?
Oh God, I get it all the time, especially inconvenient places, like on the tube.
Mm.
Is it true? Because I've just had a message from somebody up in the office that this happens to some of the girls in the office with Joel.
Yes, that's very true.
Is it?
But the rumour going around the office, apparently, upstairs, is that they think he might put something down his trousers to enhance it.
I've heard that he does as well.
Is what they're saying up there.
That's why he carries those tissues around him all the time. To put down his shorts. Oh, God. Jeez. Right, okay, listen, Teresa in Northampton. I agree with you, Scott. I don't go around looking, but sometimes you can't help but notice. There you are. Mm. I'm male and I agree. I don't go around looking at it, but it's the same. Sometimes you just can't look. See, Darren, again, sometimes at work you just notice. Helen in Warrington's the same. Charlotte in Oxford. Rachel in Worcester.
This conversation started to make me feel really
and
inadequate.
Becky in Nottingham. And any woman who says then they don't have awareness
don't try and have a look.
Is lying lying to themselves. No, that's different, you see. Now you're looking for it, you see.
Yeah. It'll take you a while.
That's different to having awareness. Now, I'm not confirming or denying anything about Jo Whiley here, because she did not want it revealed on the air, but rumour has it that Jack is notorious. You can't miss him.
Notorious B.I.G.
So you can't really blame her for having the awareness. It's not her fault, it's his.
BBC Radio 1 Podcast.
What? National. Radio 1.
It's nearly 10 to 5, so hopefully you're going home from work in 10 minutes, or worst case scenario, 40. Hey, Lisa.
Hey.
You right?
Yeah, how are you?
Very good. Thank you so much for this amazing gift that you've sent me.
No worries.
You like receiving post, don't you?
Yeah, I don't get that much post these days.
No. I received a really nice letter from somebody the other day here, and it makes it all worthwhile.
People don't write letters anymore. They just send emails. Mm. You know, like, the days of Radio 1 DJs getting a massive sack full of mail went with, like, a long time ago, didn't it?
Went with lots of old people.
Yeah. Anyway, so thanks for the present.
No worries.
Tell me what's on this thing you've sent me.
Well, I was going through some stuff the other day and I found this tape that a guy I was seeing when I was 16 gave me.
Right, how old are you now?
I'm 22.
Okay, so well, that would have been... Oh, hang on.
Oh, here we go. Come on, Carol.
2001?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Right. Well done.
Thank you very much. That's good for me.
I know, it's so difficult to take 6 years off 2007.
But I'm no good at maths. So, this is a guy you're going out with at the time.
Yes.
And what is this?
Well, it's a mixtape with loads of, like, smushy songs on and him telling me how much he likes me and waffling on and
stuff. Oh, he made you a mixtape. He must have liked you.
Yeah.
Mixtapes equal love.
Yeah. Especially when you're, like, 16. It's amazing. Right, so, I mean, I've listened to this. He obviously does like you a lot.
Yeah.
He talks forever.
It's a bit like that.
So he talks on this as well, does he?
Yeah.
Oh, so he's not just putting a load of songs together.
He's made a real effort.
Ah, right, okay.
And you thought I'd like this because you thought this is kind of my sort of humour, yeah?
Yeah.
Taking the mickey out of the people's affections.
Faults.
Okay, now I'm going to play some of this, which I know is cruel, but, I mean, I'm sure he's probably, you know, in another relationship now and he could probably see the funny side as well, don't
yeah,
you think?
Yeah, probably.
I hope so, yeah. Anyway. Can I just ask, how much longer did you go out with him after he made this tape?
Not much longer.
Well, a couple of months, or...?
If even, yeah.
Why did the tape make you reconsider things?
Well, you're about to hear. Now, I need to apologise for the quality of this, it's not very good, but I've kind of tweaked it the best I could.
Is it not digital quality?
No. We right. did find a cassette player in the Radio 1 building eventually last night.
So was it where I suggested it might be?
What, under Dave's desk?
Yeah, was it under Dave's desk
no.
or not? Right,
no.
Okay.
We did find one in the corner upstairs, right? So we're going to... I'll play this to you now, but I do apologise for the quality. We've done the best we can. All right, let's play it.
Hi, Lisa, it's me. I just thought I'd... This is what, while I was just messing around, I'd take the time to record you a little message.
Bless.
I've got some songs that I'm gonna put down on a tape, and it's a tape especially for you. And there's the songs that I know that you like.
She'll know it's on a tape because she's listening to the tape.
To us both, and that we've I feel a bit stupid doing this really in some ways, but
I don't be stupid now.
And, too late now.
Well, I just really love you. No. I love you so much. It's just the best thing really that's ever happened to me. I knew that I loved you when I first saw you ice skating, and just saw you and just fancied you so much. You just Phil, guys, this is embarrassing. You're so, so beautiful. And I know that all my mates are really jealous. And I've just been together for 6 months. So I really love you. And this was the song that was playing when we first met. I don't know if you remember, but when they did that little slow section on the ice.
Play a record!
I thought I'd play it because I play it all the time because it makes me think of us, and you've just made my life complete and just made me so happy, and you're just brilliant. You're just really brilliant.
Oh no, what is it? Oh, gross. Lisa, you're brilliant, you are. You're just brilliant.
I'm confused. Is this what you were ice skated to?
Yeah.
Okay. Go. I will never. Oh, do you remember this one?
No.
Was this your song? Lisa?
Yeah.
Yeah. This is All My Life by Casey and JoJo.
Really?
Yeah. Brilliant quality. This is what Radio 1 used to sound like all the time up until 2 years ago when we played everything off cassette. Can I go through some of the other songs on the on the
tape? Oh, you
as
might
well?
Have ruined the moment for her.
No,
also on
ahead.
Here,
is this bringing really? Back happy memories of, you know, fingerless gloves and slush puppies?
Also on here is
because ice skating, obviously. That's why. That's why. Nothing else. All right, one that doesn't speak, calm down.
Right, Gabrielle. I know, all right. Yeah, move on from it. Just Gabrielle's on here as well, right. Which is always nice. With Don't Need the Sun to Shine. I don't remember that one.
I don't remember that.
Martine McCutcheon, were you a fan of her, Lisa?
Yeah, she was all right.
Yeah. Perfect yeah. Moment is on there.
Oh,
that's nice. Two in a Million by S Club 7. That's nice. And also, well, the Cores are on there with Breathless.
Right.
This is puzzling me. The Bad Touch by the Bloodhound Gang. That's not that romantic. Do you remember the lyrics to that?
Is that the...
About doing it like they do on the Discovery Channel.
Yeah.
So, that's wrong. Oh, some people are saying this is cruel playing out this mixtape. It's a long time ago. Imagine all her... all her ex-boyfriends, if they're listening now, thinking, no, it's you next. She volunteered it, and, she said that he wouldn't mind. I don't think it's cool. Hello, Radio 1.
Hello.
Hello, who's that, please?
It's Lucy Amor from Hampshire.
Hi. How can I help?
I'm with my friend Emma, and we think that guy's lovely.
Do you?
Yeah, he sounds brilliant. I'd love a guy like that.
Would you?
Yes. He's so free, and, so thoughtful, and most guys aren't like that.
Oh, okay, so you'd like a mixtape made for you in this way?
Yeah, definitely, and also it was like the song they ice skated to, and...
No, it is quite sweet.
Oh, you're soft, aren't you?
It is. You've got to admit it.
Okay, here's some more of the mixtape.
So yeah, Lisa, this is my little mixtape that I've put together for you, just so you can hear exactly how I feel. I've done nothing but waffle, so I'm just going to keep it short and sweet with this last song that I've chosen for you, because I love you so much, and
you've
been
that.
Together for 6 months, and I'm just so
six
happy,
months.
And this song's for you. I think the lyrics say it all, really.
And it is.
Oh, what a classic! It's The Best by Tina Turner. I call you, I need you, my heart's on fire. You
come to me wild and wild. Now, if you've got any of these tapes that you'd like to send to me, maybe you received one from an ex-boyfriend or girlfriend. Have you got any, Laura? Brilliant. Okay. I do like
because you had so many boyfriends.
No, they're all from Ben from the diary.
I was going to say, some of them wouldn't have even had time to make a mixtape for you. They didn't last that long.
Send them in, please, to Scott Mills, Radio 1, London, W1N4DJ. Remember, I'm looking for everything that you've got. Send it to me, sugar. Scott Mills, Radio 1, London, W1N4DJ.
B BBC Radio 1 podcast.
Now, somebody likes these mixtapes so much, they're going to do one for their girlfriend this weekend.
Oh.
Yeah. You know it's love when a mixtape is involved. Now, we spoke to...
Don't you can still do it as a tape, though, can you?
Well, it's a CD,
it's a playlist.
Lisa was on earlier, and she was just going through loads of old stuff like you do at home, and came across this box, a cassette of... A slightly sappish ex-boyfriend was in there, so she thought, yeah, Scott would like that, and sent it to me. Now, this cassette was from 2001. We've managed to find a cassette player that works at Radio 1. The quality is quite rubbish, but have a listen, because here is the next part. We're not naming him, because that would be very unpleasant.
No, but could we just say we don't believe it is either Frank Lampard or John Terry, which a lot of people have suggested, but we don't think it is either of those two.
We can't confirm or deny that.
We don't think it is.
Does sound a bit like both of them. Mm. Right, so here's the next part of the mixtape from 2001.
We've been together 6 months. I can't quite believe it. Time seems to have gone so quick, but then... I suppose they say time flies when you're having fun, and you're just brilliant. You're just so brilliant. You're like, you're just the best thing ever. You just make me so happy. You're like the first thing I think of when I wake up in the morning, the last thing I think of when I go to bed at night. You're just amazing. You're so good looking. You're just like, you look a little bit like, I don't know, you don't look like anybody. You're just better than anybody. You're just beautiful. You're just amazing girl. And you're just so talented, and
you look like, this is, don't look like anybody
for you. I just wanted to put it all in words that you could hear, and because I'm not really confident enough saying it to you, but you are brilliant, and you're just beautiful, and we've been together 6 months, and I just love you so much, because you're just
six months.
So happy, and it's like my life is genuinely complete now that you're a part of it, and I've never thought like this before, but I've got all these plans now of like getting old with you and settling down with you.
6 months!
I'm not even a person that ever really thought about stuff like that before, but you're just so brilliant. Like, just really brilliant. Like, I'm gonna play you another song now. This is another one I've chosen. This is one of my favourites. Right.
Now, do you know what this is?
No, I have no idea what this is.
Right, this is a song called Hazard by a bloke called Richard Marks.
Right. It's a kind of smoochy.
It's not really a love song.
Sounds like a love song.
No, it's about a... It's about a bloke who murders his girlfriend.
Really?
Yep.
Right.
And then says it wasn't him.
You know a lot about Richard Marx.
Yeah, I do. Basically, to cut a very dull song short, what happens is he moves to this town.
Yeah.
People think, he's a bit weird. That boy's not right.
Right.
Then came to know Mary.
Right.
First
time 3 years ago.
Someone loved him. He saw the man inside. And they used to walk down by the river. And Mary sometimes did like to watch the sun go down. Anyway, as I was saying, they used to walk along the river.
And she was looking for the man inside.
And then occasionally what would happen is they would dream their way out of this town. Anyway, so basically, sorry, I'm going on a bit now.
No, I'm enjoying the story. Okay. See, I never knew the story behind the song.
So he meets Mary,
yeah.
Walks by the river a lot, watches the sun go down, all that crap.
Yeah.
Then she goes out walking one day, right?
Without him.
Without him. And doesn't come home. No one understood what I felt
for Mary. No one cared. Did nobody understand what I felt for her?
She never came home. God, this is boring. Anyway, right, so she goes out walking. Right, she never comes home. The police come round and accuse him of doing it, murdering her. He tells him he did it, and the music fades. Radio 1. That's it. Okay, so that's the end of the story. What a romantic song to put on a... on a mixtape.
Oh, you're just brilliant. Brilliant, Lisa. You're brilliant.
Remember, if you've got any mixtapes you want to send me, if you've got Hazard by Richard Marx on yours, send them in to the Radio 1 address. Radio 1.
This is a download from the BBC. For more information, go to bbc.co.uk/radio1. The Scott Mills Daily.